Welcome back to the last festive Fusion World Tour trailer, where we celebrate the wonderful musical talents of some of the world's finest musicians enjoying the benefits of Fusion instrument gig bags and accessories. But don't worry if you've missed any of the earlier clips, you can find the full interviews on the Fusion gig bag website. Let's get started with a guitarist turned luthier from Switzerland, Andy Hidber from Magneton Guitars. So you decided, after all the troubles you were having, to make the perfect Andy-proof guitar. How many are in the range?
Oh, that's a difficult question. I guess I have some, you can call it standard models. My Magnacaster, which is a combination of a Stratocaster and Telecaster design, with my neck and my specs and stuff. And then I used to do some Coronados, which is a quite unknown Fender model from the 60s. And I just liked the shape of it. And so I built new ones in that style. But the thing is, if you want one of my guitars, you better custom order then. I have some stock, but the most fun part is to build a guitar for a guitar player, which I'm doing right now. I have 7 orders to fulfill, so quite a lot to build.
Yeah, I think it's hard for luthiers like yourself tinkering away, making high quality guitars. You cannot afford to keep a dozen, 6 even, in stock. From one Highland area to another, Bonnie Scotland to be precise, here's a small clip of my interview with Grant MacLeod, also known as the Munro Bagpiper. I love this.
Yeah, so my local mountain, Benscreel, which is the one that I grew up at the foot of, that's always going to be a personal favourite of mine. But as you climb more, you expand your horizons, so to speak, and the mountains of Skye and Torrid and are pretty hard to beat as well.
Let's come back down to ground level. What are you up to during lockdown? Any promotions?
I was doing my videos, obviously. That was with the travel restrictions, I wasn't able to get to the Munros, so I was still able to do a version of that in my garage. So I had a green screen set up with the mountains, and I was still able to function that way. But I've started doing a few promotions for Youth Football Scotland. There's a recent one that I've just done. There's a video on my page for that.
And of course, you've got a Fusion bag, which you climb with, which has got a rain cover.
Very important in Scotland. So, yeah, it's been great. I can wrap my pipes up and they're secure, and there's space to put everything else into it as well. So all my piping stuff, and of course the stuff that I would normally need for the hill. So it's been a very practical bag, in fairness.
Well, Grant, thanks for coming in. I'm going to say, long may you climb. I've not said that line before. Thanks ever so much for the interview.
Well, it's a quote by you, so we'll keep it for you.
We're back down to earth now, and I want you to meet a trumpet-playing football fan. Here's John Hemingham.
We go up and down in numbers, but there's a hardcore of 5 or 6, and then we go up to 15. So there's quite a few, and obviously everybody affected, and it's just such a shame. There's nothing we can do about it, is there? It's just hang on in there and hope for the best when it comes out.
Yeah, that's right. But it's not just football. What else? I think you do hockey and even boxing?
Yeah, we do. We've done Vegas 5 times with Ricky Hatton with the boxing, and we do amateur boxing as well. We've done George Groves, Chris Eubank Jr., a few others. And the hockey we do for the Olympic team, so the women's and the men's Great Britain. We've done a couple of Olympics with them and other games. And so, yeah, we get around a few sports. And like I say, rugby league internationals, as well as domestic games, and, of course, the football with England, but not only the men, the women and the under 21s as well. So from a full programme to nothing, anything that we do needs a crowd, you see. So crowds at the moment are banned, and we're just stuck.
Yeah, you must be missing it big time. I mean, this is widely travelled, isn't it? Boxing matches in Las Vegas, that's just something else. Are you playing, I mean, when we hear you, we have the Steve McQueen, the Great Escape, all that sort of stuff in the background. Is there a favourite song? Sadly, we've come to the end of our festive show, but don't forget these are only teasers and you can watch all the interviews in full with all the Fusion listeners on the Fusion Gig Bag website. And there's that competition still running. You can win up to £1,000 worth of prizes. All details on the website. Well, that's it. I'm off to Hawaii to see Craig and Sarah Chi. See you next time. How you first met, I think it's brilliant that you know, you've made a career out of playing the ukulele, but I think you told me a while ago that you met after you were both on the same bill, same gigs, and got to know each other.
That is correct. Yes and no. So we actually met through a friend of ours who is a luthier, and that person was actually making instruments, making one for Craig and making one for myself. And he got us in touch because I was actually looking for a specific low G string, and Craig actually had access to an unwound one, and he sent me one, and then we met at the NAMM show and then started appearing on the same bills. And then the next thing we know, we end up together. Married and have little Cameron now.
From this house we'll build a home and grow, like a wild tale grows, and the story's always told. My lover's in the fold of a heart that beats so big. Everyone come see that moon, it's hanging like a picture in the sky. Everyone come crowd around the big old moon, shining like a diamond in the sky. And I'll meet you there, my love, the center of my mind.
Fantastic, fantastic. So when his fingers are big enough, he'll be on to four strings. I mean, you mentioned the NAMM show.